everybody, and welcome to Naomi Plays Live. That's right, we're going to be playing some Dishonored today because we're going to go back in time, check out Dishonored, because Dishonored 2 is out in November. Anyways, I want to introduce Mitchell, who is also on the mic today.
What's up, everyone?
That's right, I'm not by my lonesome like I was this Monday. So I got Mitchell, who's going to be checking in the comments. So if you're in Twitch TV chat, or if you're twitch.tv chat, or if you're on youtube.com/IGN, or if you're on Facebook, or if you're on IGN.com, wherever you are enjoying this stream today, then leave a comment, because Mitchell will be checking out those comments.
Go ahead and tweet your questions at IGN using the hashtag IGNPlaysLive, and that's probably the best way for us to get your comment read on stream.
Yeah, exactly. We're going to be interacting. Tell us your thoughts. Tell us what you hope for Dishonored 2. We have some Dishonored 2 info, of course, because we all saw the trailer at E3. But there's some things that are going to be changed and different from this version of the game, the first version back in 2012. Can you believe it's been 4 years?
It's been... God.
I feel like I just completed the game like last year or something. But yeah, it's been 4 years. So, Emily and I will count. Let's check it out. I'm excited to play this because I did play a little bit last night just to refresh my memory on how it goes. But we're gonna start back from the start.
Did you beat Dishonored way back in the day?
This is like one of the few games I've beat to completion while working at IGN, because it's a challenge otherwise. But I definitely played it and enjoyed it thoroughly. I recommended it to everybody, kind of the way I do Sleeping Dogs, because I just really love the story and kind of the world they created. It's very steampunk inspired, and like they have some cool, you know, tech going on in this game, and we're gonna see some of it in a bit.
It's like oil punk, because like the whole world of Dunwall runs on whale oil.
Whale oil, exactly, which is so interesting and fun and unique and cute, and just everything about it's very original and has the nice uniqueness to it.
Yeah, it's. Unique is a really good word for Dishonored, because you look at the art style and it's very one of a kind. Everyone has very like angular faces. Like, look at this guy, his pointy nose.
Yeah, which works because it's not graphically at the level of how games are now. So the fact that they can do it in a more almost cartoonish way, the character designs, it actually just plays nicely with the level of graphics that were available at the time.
Yeah, so
and brings it up to speed.
But more. Like, Dishonored hits a lot of different notes, right?
Like, look at this.
Yeah,
sorry to interrupt.
No, it's cool. Like, this is a really cool way to introduce you to this world of, like, you know, they go into this dock, and instead of just the dock being at the water level of where they get off, they have to actually drop in the water to make it rise up.
Yeah.
And it's just kind of a cool, like, interesting technology.
Elevator. Yeah, totally. So, sorry for interrupting.
No,
really,
it's fine.
But I wanted to point it out.
I was just going to say, like, Dishonored, it's a really interesting original IP that kind of checks all the boxes, where it provides an interesting gameplay hook of being this Deus Ex-y kind of game where you have a choice of approaching any given situation from a stealth perspective or a going loud perspective, and you have all these powers to help along both of those avenues. And it's a really, I'm so glad that Dishonored exists.
Me too, and I'm so glad they're making a second one, and it's coming out soon. It's coming out November 11th this year. I'm gonna tell her to keep talking. But yeah, I think that the cool thing is you can go about your assassinations and whatever it is you're doing, your missions, really uniquely every time, and choose kind of the way you want to go. I cannot play like all out murderer or the ghost
full
version.
On stealth.
Yeah, like full on stealth, because it depends on the situation for me. I'm not like, I can't be perfect for any one of those. I can't be the extreme of each side of that coin. So I just try to do, you know, however I can manage to beat a level, whether that's killing some people and not all, or killing everybody, or not killing anybody.
Right, but that's cool, because Dishonored allows for that kind of playstyle. You
it
can
does.
Totally go that middle of the road kind of thing, where you try stealth, and if stealth doesn't work out, then you have options to deal with the enemies if they, you know, all come after you.
Yep. Another thing though is there is some incentive to play stealth, because in this game, the first Dishonored, if you kill more people, then there's more of the plague happening in the world, and it's a darker outcome.
Mm-hmm.
So that's important to note, where your actions do affect the actual storyline of what happens. And you create more chaos, you get a kind of darker outcome. If you create less or very low chaos, everything turns out great. At least the best possible outcome that you can get.
And it's one of those games also. It's one of those games also that has like multiple endings depending on what kind of playstyle you adopt, which I always love. In Dishonored 2, I think they're adopting the low chaos ending as the canonical ending.
Yeah, they chose the best possible outcome ending to continue on from that point on. I love this that you can just like, almost. Be out of cover, but not out of cover when you just peek on over the side.
Yeah, it's really
useful,
too. And she
doesn't know. I can totally... Oh, maybe she did see me. Not here. Nope. Sorry. I think that the... just the way that you can go about playing the game makes it interesting. We should go now. And I love the characters and the story. It's all really good. Okay. She gave up art, I think. Yay.
Will you give me more climbing lessons?
She's super cute. So Emily is the character you're going to get to play as, or have the option to play as, in Dishonored 2.
Yep. Emily and Corvo. Come on.
Is she getting mad at me? But yeah, I think like, it's not like you can alternate between the two, right? It's once you play Emily, you play through the entirety of the story as Emily, or you play as Corvo. And Emily's the more gun, like, going in guns blazing.
Do you know the differences between their powers? Because actually, I don't. I don't know at all.
I don't know. There's supposed to be a ton of new powers. If you look at the trailer, there's so many different... The way that the powers look themselves, the way that the powers work. Like, I think there's one where you can mimic killing somebody with multiple enemies. So
yeah,
if you're in a room of four, you kill one guy one way, and that kills all the rest of the... group.
Yeah, I believe
all
that power is called Domino.
Yeah. Okay, so you do know a little bit about the powers.
Yeah. So I know about
the
powers.
I tried to research that and I couldn't find anything.
I know the powers because we actually did a Dishonored 2 live stream with the developers
so there you go.
In-house.
So that helped.
Yeah, that helped.
So Domino. I love that. That was really cool to me when I saw that in the trailer.
Yeah. The question is, the question that I wonder is, what's the difference between the powers between Emily and Corvo? Like, do both of them have Domino? Is that something that both of them can get, or is that something that only Emily has?
From what I read, it sounds like Corvo has a lot of the same powers from the first game.
Okay.
And that he sticks to that, and then Emily's the one with the more. So it's almost like you probably want to play as Emily. I think. I mean, well, then you have to choose. Okay, do I want to go stealth or full on murderer? But
right.
But I don't know. There's incentives for both, I feel like.
We have a question from Nalum.
Yes.
What change would you like to see in Dishonored 2? Was there anything about Dishonored 1 that you weren't a huge fan of? Mother,
look. Nothing really. Emily, come here. I think even it still holds up.
This is also a big important part.
Yes, very big important.
Daud,
you a Daud. Whoops, this guy's behind me. I just have to defend her for a second here. Look out! Another one. This is a big part. This is a part of the... Corvo, it even carries over into Dishonored 2. The story that happens in... sense, because it's a sequel. I don't know what I was going with that train of thought, but I think that it's just a very... Like, even in the trailer, you see there's a kind of homage to... Jasmine here, and you know, because they're still honoring her death,
Corvo,
even in the second game.
Coming apart. Find Emily, protect her. You're the only one.
I mean, she didn't have it easy. She had the plague and the rats, with carrying the plague around the city, like Corvo. Pretty much a zombie apocalypse.
Yeah, the
is
world
what she had to deal with.
this world is not a world I would ever want to live in.
Well. True. I don't think I would either, but that said, I think it'd be cool if it was, you know, everything politically was sound and the world was, you know, kind of It's just based out, you know, based in with the whale oil and everything going on in the world. Just the style too, like the buildings, the architecture. If it could maintain that, but kind of be in a, you know, a very nice and utopian, you know, everyone's kind to each other, very peaceful environment. That would be really cool.
I would rather visit than actually
really?
Hunker down, live in the world of Dunwall.
I would live in Dunwall. The people seem fun. I don't know.
Plague going around.
Okay, but minus the plague.
Minus the plague.
All the negative stuff.
Minus all the bad things that make Dunwall Dunwall.
Everything about the style and the steampunk aesthetic to it, I love.
Yeah.
I would totally want to live, at least for like a month. Experience this. Maybe a year.
So we got another question, again from Nalum.
Yes.
I think this one is directed at me. Mitch, what do you think of the voice acting in the game? I feel the use of traditional actors instead of voice actors did not add anything to the game. Did you have thoughts on that?
I know I do.
Oh,
you do? Okay. I thought the voice acting in Dishonored 1 was amazing. Like, a lot of... I think there was a lot of interesting use. Yeah, like even when you're going through different parts of the missions, you're meeting people and they all have a different sound to their voice. They all have a uniqueness about them and they all sound convincing in the delivery of the dialogue, especially the women in the game. I just found very pleasant. But I think now they're going with like some more... they're going with bigger actors, right? Like Sam Rockwell's voicing a character and Rosaria Dawson and who else is? Like, basically, I think there's another Daredevil actor in there.
Yeah, so the big thing about Dishonored, and it was the same with the original game, actually, also. Like, there were a ton of Hollywood voice actors in this game. Susan Sarandon.
I don't even remember. Okay, so Susan Sarandon.
Susan Sarandon was in this game.
I didn't even pay attention to that when I was playing the first game.
John Slattery is in this game, who is Roger from Mad Men. Michael Madsen is Dowd. The voice acting is solid. But that's the thing. It's just solid to me. It's good. But... You know, they made a big deal about this cast, and I'm sure they paid so much money
to
get those actors. And it just, you know, I don't think it elevated the game in a way that maybe they would have wanted that Hollywood cast to elevate the performance of the game. Like, I think Michael Madsen, in the DLC he does fine, but in the actual game it kind of feels like he phones a little bit of it in.
Oh, that's a bummer.
And especially compared to what you know Michael Madsen can do. I mean, he's an amazing actor. But I wasn't a huge fan of his performance as Dowd.
That's so straight. I had, like, no clue there were all these big actors in the first game. So I'm just like, I thought they were really pleasant, but I didn't really notice. I don't now knowing that they're all, a lot of them are star actors, I would have to kind of take a different analysis or analyze with a different approach. But, well... I think you have a solid opinion about that, because they're still doing sort of the same thing. Oh, shoot.
That was bad.
Yeah, I know. They're going to come after me now. But there's not that many guys, luckily.
All right, let's see some parries, Naomi. Parries and stabs. Parries and stabs. Someone help me out. There you go.
Love it. I don't know if they have anything of value. Probably not. But yeah, I feel like... Wow, I had no idea there was all these star actors. Like, Susan Sarandon's huge.
Yeah, for sure.
But I like Sam Rockwell. Rosaria Dawson. Who else is in this game? Or in the second one? I think there's going to be Vincent D'Onofrio.
I love him.
D'Onofrio?
Yeah, the
D'Onofrio.
Kingpin from
right.
Daredevil.
Yeah, so like two actors from Daredevil in this game.
Second
game.
You don't really see that... done that often where video games go for this like stunt casting kind of thing where
kind of how they do it in the CGI movies like Up and whatnot.
Yeah, it's interesting to see. I don't know if it's the right decision because like I said,
maybe not worth the money.
It's got to be so much more money
to
get those Hollywood actors into this game.
Yeah, and someone who's experienced in voicing, like, there's so many star video game voice actors, like Troy Baker and Nolan North, and those are the only two I can think of right now. But Jane Iredale, she's one of them.
Yeah, but I think it's...
But I think...
No, I was going to say, I think it's an interesting experiment to see, like, can a Hollywood cast...
Sorry, I'm like, not paying attention here. Oh, I only had one bullet.
Can a Hollywood cast draw the same level of interest that they might draw with, like, you know, a TV show or a movie? And it's especially relevant in today's age right now because there's a video game voice actor strike going on.
That's true. I heard about that. Well, it's a video game actor talent debate with SAG-AFTRA. It's going to be, I don't know. I wonder what the outcome's going to be for that.
Yeah.
Very intriguing. Okay. Kind of trying to remember. I literally played this yesterday, but my memory's a little shot right now. Da-da-da-da.
All right, I'm going to check out Twitter here. Thank you for the question, Nalum.
Yeah, really good question. Luckily, Mitchell knew a lot about it. Oh, wait, this is worse.
I'm a voice acting nerd, so... Cobra Commander on Twitter said that Stephen Russell, the original Garrett, is Corvo in Dishonored 2, and he sounds awesome. I haven't actually heard him, but that's cool that they're going into their thief backlog.
Yeah. Thief pool of actors.
All right, find the explosive.
Yeah.
This is also, like, I love games with good openings, and this is another
story,
great opening sequence.
Yeah, very epic. I mean, we're about to blow some stuff up, so.
Like, it pulls you in right away with the murder of the Empress, and then you get thrown into this prison where you have to kind of learn basically the core mechanics of Dishonored, and yeah, you're exposed immediately to the different choices that you have in terms of going loud or going quiet.
I think that the way they did the tutorial too was really, I don't know, it felt non-invasive, like didn't bother me that it was kind of showing me the ropes through those little, like, it'll give you a description, it'll show you what it looks like, how it's executed. I like that. Okay, so cool, that's it. I just gotta place the bomb. Go next. Okay, I guess I can sneak on in that guy. Nope. He was too fast for me. Oh, I think I do remember this guy. Slug. Did you patrol
the yard? Sorry, not yet. I was gonna report
a bunch of people in the chat didn't know that there was a voice actor strike. There is a voice actor strike going on right now. It is a big deal.
Yep.
The main union for not just video game voice actors, but just voice actors in general, are striking against a bunch of different publishers, including Activision and Warner Brothers, pretty much all the main video game publishers. Because at the core of it, they want residuals, and honestly, not that much. Like, it's $800 if a game sells 2 million units. But that's probably not a conversation that we should have for Dishonored. I'm sorry. Like I said, I'm a voice actor nerd. This is something that I follow very closely.
Definitely, it's good to keep yourself informed. So if you do, if you do have an interest in it, look up those details. I mean, it's an important movement.
Yeah. It very well could change the way that video games cast.
Yep. Everything about it. Even media houses like IGN, but we'll go to that later. Let me just see here. Okay, he's not really in the video. I know I have to take that guy down full show. Because I need to get in that little control room. Okay, hopefully he doesn't turn around. No! How is he not seeing me right now? Oh, God.
Oh, God. He sees you now.
He sees me now.
You gotta go loud. Stab him in the neck.
Oh, what's it telling me now? Oh, they off balance. Yeah, there you go.
That works. Slice or stab.
I don't think I can get out of this alive. Oh, maybe I spoke
too. Not with that attitude.
Not so bad. All right. I thought for sure. What? I thought there was like a broken. Oh, here. I thought for sure I would die in that. Because I'm playing on normal, so. It's going to be a little more challenging. I don't remember if I played on normal my first go around. Oh, man. I'm just, like, not even being careful to who I'm alerting here.
That looked like That looked like he was knighting him, but went too far down with the knighting. Like, oh god! You're just supposed to tap my shoulder.
Well, killed a lot of people. It's gonna be a plague-filled game, guys. A lot of plagues and rats going around. Multiple plagues. Set that bomb off. Woo! No! Wait, was I supposed to close this door? I don't think I was.
Explosion!
In any case, I survived that. Not as big as an explosion as I thought I'd get.
So I know that you said that you typically go in the middle when it comes to stealth and action when it comes to games like this.
Not this time.
Oh, not this time. You're just
well,
going
I guess this
total...
time I'm just I'm doing it the murdering way, but
the murder friendly route,
the evil way.
Typically, do you enjoy? Okay, so you usually try to go for stealth.
I do.
Okay.
Like huge Splinter Cell fan, which I think this game really kind of. In some ways, has similar properties to that.
I think every stealth game owes a debt of, you know, gratitude to Splinter Cell. I mean, you can see, like, looking through all... It's not just Splinter Cell. Thief is probably, I think,
the
biggest inspiration for Dishonored.
Yeah.
Then you got Deus Ex. And like I said, every stealth game kind of owes stuff to Splinter Cell, too.
Kind of changed the game with that stuff. With how to play stealth and... I don't know. Very secret agent, like, which I am not right now. I'm just a. Well, I was a bodyguard, and now here I am, assassinating people. Oh, those guys are totally gonna die.
The rats! Come on, they're just rats. They're just rats.
Like they couldn't just stomp on them. Oh, so apparently in Dishonored 2, it's not rats anymore. It's gonna be like flies.
Yeah, blood flies. I think they're called.
Yeah, blood flies, which to me is way worse because it's like flying spiders, you know?
Yeah.
You'd rather that they're not able to fly. In any case, like regardless of even birds, you know, shouldn't be able to fly. It's just like if they're carrying a plague, you don't want anything flying around you.
Yeah.
That might give you the plague.
And it kind of makes sense, like, you know, that they're blood flies, so they kind of feed off like the blood and the chaos that's going on in the world that you're causing.
Yes, and which I am causing.
Apparently they can even create like blood fly zombie things.
What?
So, yeah, like it's interesting how Dishonored is able to add these extra elements depending on what kind of style you play. So, in a way, it kind of makes the game harder if you don't go stealthy.
Which I should probably start doing from this point on. Go stealth. I'm going to try. But can't guarantee anything. I also love some of the secrets, you know, because it's a linear game, but there's like, every now and then you'll come across like a hidden place with a bunch of items that you could use.
Yeah, so one of the things...
And it's fun to explore those.
One of the things I think is the best about Dishonored is its progression system. And like you said, with the secrets, finding those secrets is just so rewarding because you get these bone charms, you get these abilities to add more powers to your repertoire, and... It's just fun to experiment with.
Yeah, I think at one point we have a heart, a beating heart that lures us to.
Yeah.
What was it called? It was just a heart, right?
It's some kind of heart that beats faster when you're closer to a bone charm.
Like a heart radar or heart. It was very back in the day when I. It's almost that. I guess that's one thing that I hope they keep. A lot of the made Dishonored so cool were these different ways you could go about. Finding these secrets, if they keep the heart, or I wonder if they're going to go with something different.
I know, supposed
to use the bodies.
Yeah,
for...
I know I made fun of the rats earlier, but don't underestimate those rats.
No, they will eat you alive.
They will eat you alive. Go, go, go.
Oh, no,
oh God, the
me,
rats, the
me.
Rats.
Whoa, I guess that body wasn't enough for them. Should I, like, throw multiple?
I think you should probably throw it a little bit farther also.
Oh, like this way, maybe?
Yeah, farther away from the wheel. And maybe put another one there. That's all right. Just go for it.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
No. This is not going to work. What the heck, rats? What? That was weak. Just trying to throw as far as possible. Okay, I don't think I have time. They eat that thing, like, so fast. It's a whole body, but it takes them, like, nothing but... It's, like, under a minute, and the body's just bone. creepy. And, oh, yeah.
The outsider walks among us.
What else can I do here?
Do you know what character Sam Rockwell plays in Dishonored 2? Is it the outsider?
I took some notes. It's not... If it's from this story, you mean?
It's not the outsider, is it? The outsider is a character from the story.
I don't know who voiced the outsider for this one. Do you know?
I don't remember.
I have it down here. He's playing Mortimer Ramsey.
Okay.
I
don't know who that
is,
but...
a new character that we're going to get to discover. Here's the secret spot. You can, like, tripwire this. And then kind of almost didn't get hit by that.
Too smart for that trap.
Anyone there?
What do you think?
There was someone.
What do you think of, like, the supernatural elements of Dishonored?
The powers?
Well, no, I mean, like, in terms of, like, the enemies that you fight. I always like... So I understand, like, the need for enemy variety, but in games like this where, like, you can mess around with, like, the enemy AI before, like, you kill them, it always bums me out when I go against, like, a monster or something that I can't do that kind of stuff to.
Oh, that's
like,
true.
Like, I just have to shoot it or sneak up on it.
Where you're like, I have no choice but to just use my gun.
Yeah.
Yay. That's exciting. I don't know. I even saw in Dishonored 2 they're going to have robots, right? Or like more steampunky type tech. And you're going to be fighting off robots or some android looking.
Yeah, no, I didn't.
Creatures.
I didn't see that part. But I did see like they had like the hellhounds that. I think these are also in Dishonored 1, but they start out as little like skulls. And then if they see you, they actually transform into dogs. And they don't die unless you actually break the skull. They'll keep on respawning.
Well, that's shitty. I mean, shiitake mushroom. Sorry. Oh man, I've. Why didn't it let me trigger that? That's so weird. Okay, I just gotta sprint and run. Oh, that's what it's telling me to do.
Oh god.
That's too close.
Come on, you can do it.
I'm like prepping here. Man, I slid for a long time, even in all that rubble. Felt like I was on a floor of marble. Oh, this is where. I think, something like this, for example, where you're supposed to find where they marked this, the code for the safe.
Yeah.
Don't know where that is, so we're going to have to do that later. But that's stuff you can go back and replay the game and, you know, look for all those Easter eggs. They're fun.
Yeah. Or, you know, it's something in there to reward exploration. And this is a game that very much so rewards exploration.
It does, yeah.
Because, like I said, the progression system in this game is fantastic, and... The more cool stuff you find, the more cool powers you're going to have and the more options you're going to have with dealing with these situations.
Yeah. What are they? Like the runes, right?
It's the runes and the bone charms.
Like the charms.
I don't remember exactly, but I feel like the bone charms had like random effects, like or like the placement of them was random. So you can have a playthrough where you have different effects than, you know, if you to start a new game.
That's lovely.
Oh, that's totally true. Pelagius said you could just ask the chat for the combination.
Oh,
we have that technology.
We do have them at our disposal. does anyone know? Maybe not, actually.
It'll be like our codec. Blip,
blip. Yeah.
Archon.
They're like our oracle.
We need a code for this safe.
Totally.
We'll wait 2 minutes.
Shucks. Okay, next one we see, we're going to ask you guys.
All right.
Okay, I'm a little unaware of my... situation here. Gotta. Hopefully. You think they'll see me if I'm up here? Not if I'm behind this plank. These multiple planks of wood. Oh, yeah. I love that you can. Another cool thing about the stealth is you could bypass most or some missions without even being seen or just, you know, climbing up on. Like, if I'm up here, they're not going to see me. Which is cool. As long as you're in stealth mode. I don't think there's... I'm trying to think of another game that did something like that. But this is the only one I know. Like, this is the only one I can think of.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try to jump down.
I always try to go for the high roads.
Yeah.
In
you can climb everywhere. It's great. Don't know.
Diplonus on Twitch says the code was honestly right in front of you guys.
It was?
Yeah.
On the wall or something?
I don't know. I don't remember.
I wish I had like a bottle I could distract him with, but okay, maybe if I go down. I almost dropped down there. Ooh, that would have been bad. Okay, maybe if he turns around. Or maybe if I just jump in the water, will they hear that? Oh, maybe down here. Okay, I'm in stealth mode. He's not going to see me. At least let's hope. I don't know if the copper wire is good for anything. Do you remember if the copper wire it's useful? Because I see it everywhere.
Maybe making spring traps?
Oh, maybe.
I don't remember. I'm pretty sure there's a crafting system in this game, isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like it's made for making spring traps something like that.
So I'm like, I feel like copper wire is something that's useful in most games. So I will keep that copper wire handy. All right, we made it. This is so cool.
Once again, guys, you can tweet at us using the hashtag IGNPlaysLive. Let me pull that up for you. Tweet at IGN using the hashtag IGNPlaysLive. We will answer your question.
Oh, he's one of my favorite characters, I remember. And I work for some good people. I just like his voice. So who voices him? Do you know?
I have no idea.
Ugh, useless. No, I'm kidding.
I'm sorry.
I thought you knew everything about me.
I'll go back to my desk.
All right, old man.
Naomi fired me.
Oh, God. Isn't the election soon?
Next Tuesday, I believe.
Oh, my gosh. You know, if I could vote, I would. But I cannot. Because I'm Canadian.
Not with that attitude, you can't.
Just everything. Not with that attitude. Cool. I'm having fun playing this.
This is
the Hound Pits
pub. This is a really cool game.
Yeah.
I think
I might go back and just play it for shots and giggles.
Shots and giggles. Shiitake mushrooms and giggles.
And see if I can play the whole thing stealth. Because there's an achievement for that, right? If you play the whole
thing
without
killing
anyone. I have a sad story. My mug, my infamous bloodied up knuckle mug, brass knuckle mug. It got cracked. Somebody cracked. It wasn't me. I had left it in the kitchen at IGN. And last time I used it, I saw that it had like a little chip on the handle. And the more I held onto it, I heard it cracking, like starting to crack. And I decided to discontinue it because it would probably just shatter if I continued using it. So I don't know what happened to it. It's a big mystery. In any case, I'm trying to figure out how to get another one because I don't see the original site that sells them only has a gold and a black version, like gold and black, silver and a gold version. And I contacted them to see if they still have the bloodied version because that's my favorite.
All right, guys, YouTube and Twitch chat, I want you to not type anything. We're going to have a moment of silence for Naomi's brass knuckle mug.
Oh, thanks, Mitchell. I was wondering why you were like just talking in the chat after that. Okay, here goes. Until the Lord Regent
purged those of us who wouldn't. I can't do it. It's too awkward.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
That failed.
So the guy on the right, I know he is voiced by Roger. I was gonna say Roger Slattery. Roger from Mad Men. Just for John Slattery, God, can't speak.
That's also a difficult name to pronounce.
Yeah. But, yeah, he's again, one of those characters that I think you watch him in Mad Men and you're just like, wow.
This guy.
This guy is, like, one of the best TV actors currently on television. And then, like, he's in Dishonored and he's just like, whatever.
Yeah.
It's okay, I guess.
He's a voice in a game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This guy on the left looks like Hugo Weaving.
Yes. You think it's based off him? That'd be crazy.
I'm not in a position to say. Matt J. Sauer says, RIP mug, 2011 to 2016.
It's true. I know. I'm definitely developing. I'm going to keep it forever, regardless. But maybe if I make a shrine for it or something. I just really hope they get back to me on if they can get me that exact version, because I was really sad when I went to the site and they didn't have it anymore. I was like, no! My mug. It's like part of me. I can't not have that mug. There's the whale oil.
There's the whale oil.
So cool. Will you get a new tank from
upstairs, please? Poor whales, though.
Yeah, the whales, though.
Poor maybe whales.
Maybe it's one of those things where they just have a lot of whales in this world.
Yeah, maybe whales are like
a problem.
Salmon or something.
Yeah, like over the top, like the air. It's like too populated, too populated.
I can't imagine what the ocean would look like if that was the case.
It would be, yeah.
I guess that would rise. More whale than water.
Yeah. It would definitely like rise the water level to, like, I wonder if I don't know. I'm getting too deep into this train of thought that I started. It's like, I'm not going to go there. I'm going to stop while I'm ahead.
Can you see normally? Nalum, let me know that Billy Lush voiced the Outsider.
Cool.
I don't know
Billy
who that
Lush?
Is. I have no idea who that is. But thank you.
Yeah. Upgrades for your gear,
weapons, munitions. Yeah, this guy kind of sounds like Otacon, actually. Scavenge
the city for valuables and sell them on the black market. But see, that's what I'm talking about. Like, every actor they chose for this game has a unique sound. And I don't know that I've noticed it in other games as much as I did for Dishonored. I was like, oh, like, I can really tell that, like, it helps for when you're playing stealth, too, because you're like, I know who I'm going to kill in that room, because I can make out which voice is the one I'm supposed to kill.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's have a look, dude. Cool. I'm going to get a lot of sleep bolts, because those are always handy. Oops, what did I do here? Oh, did I already out-purchase everything?
Yep.
I'm out of money.
But that's the decision you have to make. Do you want to
go in? I think I get the crossbow
in,
at some point.
Do you want to go in fully stocked, or do you want to have something that will help you out in a future harder mission?
That's true. Well, we'll have to see. I'm sure I'm going to get some grenades along the way. And sleep well. Now it's about sleeping. Yay, we're about to sleep in a game. So exciting.
So John Mason has been asking this question a bit in Twitter. Are you upset with the Wii U being left behind? And if you had to be someone from this game, who would you be?
Okay.
Two-part question.
I am sad because the Wii... I feel bad that I had a Wii U, like, day one. Like, I purchased that Wii U. I was like, yes! I'm going to play all the Nintendo games. It's going to be great. And then, like, I don't know, 6 months in, I hadn't touched it for, like, a week. And then it became a month. And then it, like, just went on. I just neglected my Wii U, and it made me really sad. And then when they announced that they were discontinuing, I'm like, I didn't even get to play it that much. My Wii U is just like all by itself, and now is no longer relevant in our world.
So I haven't been following that story closely, but I'm not sure what's true, but I think Nintendo came out and said that that was just an unsubstantiated rumor that the last line of Wii U's are going in production. But
I mean, covered it.
Oh, yeah?
Definitely covered it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know for sure. But, I mean, it seems like it would make sense, right? Like, the Switch is coming out soon. The Wii U is... There's not even any more new games that are announced for you right now.
That's true.
So, you know, console cycles end. It's a sad fact of life.
It is. But I feel like before, from now until the Switch comes out, I might just play the heck out of my Wii U and give it its right, like, give it proper time. And then I can say goodbye, and it'll be a little easier, because I would have played a lot out of it, gotten a lot out of it. Otherwise, what was the other question that he had?
If you had to be a character in this world, who would you be? I would be the Outsider, because he's basically God.
Yeah. And nobody knows, like, his origin, right? Or do we find out at some point in the story? I don't remember.
I don't even remember, honestly.
Yeah. Like, who is this guy who's, like, coming into my life? Like, why me? I guess because... You know, the important cause is to, I remember this. This is
Link.
Cool. I love that function. It's gotten me out of really bad situations.
I feel like this power is basically the core of Dishonored.
Yeah.
Like, Dishonored wouldn't exist if it didn't have the Blink power up.
That's very true. Okay, wait, this part's like a little more challenging because it's like real far away. No, what I thought it would do. I knew it would happen because I didn't aim it properly. Yeah, I love this power. It's that and What? Oh, I'm out of mana. Thankfully, I have just enough to... What?
I think you might have to jump and then do the
no,
blink.
That's not possible.
It's not possible?
I don't think I could do that.
Okay, there you go. I'm pretty sure you can do that.
Like, jump high enough so that I can...
Well, just jump forward and then release the...
Okay, wait, let's restart that. Yeah, I know what you're saying. I know exactly
Rewind
what you're
it.
Saying. I get the logic of it. Okay, let's maybe practice it here.
I understand the theory.
Not get too far, yeah. Oh, see, like, right there I should have... Okay.
I think you gotta... So, hold it down before you jump, and then when you're jumping, as you're going down, just let go.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Okay, there you go. Oh, shoot. Okay.
Well,
I actually did it. I got it. Okay. I see what you're saying, so... Whoa, no! What? I was out of mana! Shoot! This is way... Like, this should be way easier. We're making this so complicated. I'm learning a new thing that I didn't know was possible. Okay, wait. My mana's so low. Do I have, No, I don't. Well, I don't really need it for here. So let's just do this. Okay, I might need it for here, though. So you said hold down.
Yeah, also what you can do is just... Or you can just move as close as you can to the edge without going over. And just try to aim it so that you get that little icon that shows that you can go up. There you go.
There you go. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of it now.
But you're learning some advanced techniques right now, Naomi.
Yeah, I've never... I don't think I've ever... When I played the first time, I don't think I ever did that. Or maybe I did, and I just forgot that you could do that.
Check back there. I think there might have been a chest.
Oh, that floating thing. Okay. Cool. I think I also missed... Whoops. I missed another one, too. There's some mana. Yay! Oh. So once I get this function down, I'm going to be home free. It's very useful for not... dying, like falling from high places too. Love it. All right, making our way through this dream sequence, which I actually think is pretty good. Everyone remembers Half-Life, right? It kind of has that feel to it. I feel like the Half-Life ending. Spoilers.
You know, this is my shameful gamer admission. I have never beaten Half-Life 2 to completion.
Oh no.
Oh no!
But you beat Half-Life 1.
No.
No?
No.
What? The ending of Half-Life?
I know. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Immediately, everyone stops watching.
Like, just, I'm leaving.
Yeah. Sorry. Peace out.
It was fun while it lasted, Mitchell. The heart of a living thing. What was the other
Here's
thing?
Here's that heart you're getting.
Yes. Okay. We got the beating heart, which is sometimes annoying. I gotta admit. I remember
Bruce
getting because it's like, yeah. Who is the outsider? I have no clue.
So we actually had a good comment that was explaining it. So the outsider is not a god, to be honest. He was once a man who became connected to the void in some weird way. He then got to know the future and everyone's last moments of life. He also gained power, says Lars Geertz on YouTube, and then on Twitch, we had Nalum say something. The outsider is basically a kinder, I can't pronounce that word, Nyarlathotep. From the Cthulhu mythos.
Whoa. That's some deep knowledge. Good for you, dude. That's like amazing knowledge. I had no clue. I guess if you go to their wiki, I'm sure it's all there. I'm going to try to get over here. Let's see if it's... Whoa. Okay, probably should have bolted down there. Well, that's crazy. I had no idea. All right, we're getting closer to the... Why do I keep doing that? Getting closer to the heart, the beating heart. It's a rune. We're going after a rune. Beating heart is
a rune, you say?
Yes.
With the beating heart?
Yes. See, look at how. Look at that. It's crazy. It feels weird, too. why? Why is it making me do that? Oh, because I need to use it. I'm using it already. To equip the. No centuries. I did! Oh, I see what he's saying. Okay. Yeah. But I'm supposed to. Okay, it's. I don't like it there. I'm gonna do this instead. So like this, and then you are here, wonderful.
Do you have any shameful gamer admissions of games you haven't beaten?
Yes, I revealed it the other day when, I don't remember on which stream, but I never played any of the Gears of War games, so that's a big one. I feel like.
That's not nearly as shameful as not beating Half-Life or Half-Life 2, so.
I know, but. But it's it's along those lines. Like, I feel like I know Half-Life's a massive game, but like I didn't play all the Fallout games. Like, I played a bit of Fallout 2. Fallout 4 was like the one I played the most of, and that was it. So I feel like I have a few, because a lot of the games that I have played, I played like halfway through and then I stopped. Like Witcher, I couldn't finish that one. Like, yeah. There's just a lot of games like that where I start a little bit and I get a sense of the world and I'm like, I'm going to play this to completion, but then something comes up, new game or what have you, and then...
All right, so what power are you going to go for here? Or do you have to go with Dark Vision?
Looks like it, yeah. Yeah, I need... I can go with Vitality. I think I'm going to go Vitality. Well, I use my Dark Vision. I could use some Dark Vision, actually, because that's my second favorite power in this. Okay. Well, let's just get this going, and then I'll get it later. Just gotta get more runes, I guess.
How you use what I have given you falls upon
you. I also saw... So you see the outsider in the trailer, and you can... Because I always found that this part was... He looked just not as... I don't know, like... His features are kind of mushed and... I don't know. I feel like they did a much better job with the second one from what I saw in the trailer. It's a gameplay trailer, so it's pretty close to what the game will look like. Like, the detail of the hands or the detail of the world is a lot better than this version, of course. So the Outsider looks really awesome in Dishonored 2, at least from what we've seen. You've been marked.
We got some good gamer confessions in chat.
Yeah, tell me.
Cyberman.
So I don't feel so bad and guilty.
Cyborg Man has never beaten a BioShock game.
Oh, okay. That's a big one.
That's pretty good.
That's a big one.
Guys, let us know your shameful gamer confessions.
I love that.
Don't let us be the only ones
shaming ourselves.
By talking about games that we haven't beaten or haven't played.
Okay, I'm definitely going to be able to get Dark Vision, I think, after this. Or I should be able to get something.
Abstract Abs, this is a big one.
Oh.
Never played a Legend of Zelda game.
What?
Not one. Ooh.
Ooh, that's harsh.
You know, though, I can understand that, like, if you weren't brought up a Nintendo fan.
Which I wasn't. I played the 3DS a lot for a lot of my Nintendo games. Or rather, my Zelda games.
But Abstract Abs, I'm telling you this now. Before, like, you gotta at least play one.
Just one.
So you can know what the big deal is about.
What? Oh, I can't yet. Okay. Yeah, you need to. Which one would you recommend, Mitchell, to start?
You know, I feel like a lot of people would say Link to the Past,
but I'm gonna
go with Ocarina of Time.
Yeah, that's actually I thought you were definitely gonna say Ocarina of Time. Is it Ocarina or Ocarina?
You know, we could debate it all day.
But you're Ocarina, for sure. You're in that
boat. I alternate between them. That's how much I care about it.
Yeah, I would say Ocarina of Time, for sure. And if not, Link Between Worlds was my second favorite, I think. That's the one where you turn into a cartoon, right? Drawing on the wall?
Yeah, Link Between Worlds.
Yeah,
they have that mechanic.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
You turn into graffiti.
Yeah, but it's really unique and fun how it works in the game. So I'd say definitely one of those two. First off, I know that assassination is dark. Get on it, Abstract, and let us know.
Good men have to do bad things.
When you do.
Our purpose is clear. We want to restore Her Majesty's line by finding and putting Emily Caldwin on the throne. To those ends.
Yeah. See here, this is kind of bland. I agree with you. Needs a little more oomph.
Piece by piece. Tonight, High Overseer Campbell.
Oh, you're talking about his acting?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? Like this would be fine if it was a live action show because you can see his face. You can, you know, it's grounded. But voice acting is a very different thing where you need to kind of give a little more because we can't see what your face looks like when you're doing this. We just go by what the animators are putting on. Assuming she's alive. That's the gist of it. Remember. And yeah, it's just kind of boring, isn't it?
Yep. I totally see what you're talking about now. I hear what you're talking about.
Campbell is holding a former overseer by the name of Martin. He's one of us. And if you manage to
Samuel, my favorite. He's the best.
I imagine that must be like a hell for a voice director too, to like, you know, have this big name Hollywood star and being just like, could you just give me a little more?
Just a little more of something. Oh, maybe I should find if they have a rune here, because that would be helpful. Yes. Okay. Oh, that thing's going to eat me alive. Can I kill that fish piranha?
Couple more people with confessions saying, King Steven says, never played any of the Elder Scrolls games.
Oh, like Skyrim and...
Yeah, Skyrim, Morrowind. I had not played one until Skyrim, so that's not that bad. But you should probably play Skyrim.
That's my thing, too. Yeah. Definitely play... If they're... I mean... Who knows? Skyrim's be... Like, it's another big thing now. Like, it's being talked about. You think they're going to... They're coming out with a second one, right?
A second Skyrim?
Or just... Yeah. I mean, I would assume, eventually.
Nothing's been announced right now. I think they're probably going to stick with Elder Scrolls Online for a little bit. Yeah, I don't anticipate a new Elder Scrolls game anytime, you know, within the next year or two.
It takes a long time. I mean, it took 4 years for this one, for Dishonored 2 to come out, or to be completed. It's crazy. But it's out in November! That's like super soon, because we're in November right now. Can you believe it?
It's like 2 weeks.
I feel like I just celebrated New Year's.
And we got Watch Dogs 2 coming out, too.
That's true. That's why I was playing the first one. Oh my god, there's so many games I just want to keep playing. Like Watch Dogs 1.
It's an exciting
time. I want
to
restart this one again. All stealth. Not kill anybody. It does take time. But now I got Dark Vision. Woo!
Woo!
Ready to go.
Yes, please, Samuel, take me to the next destination where I'm going to assassinate a baddie. Oh, wait. I didn't activate something. Shoot. The poison that is... Okay, so, like, there's a mission where a guy gets poisoned, or you can prevent from getting poisoned. I just didn't activate it, unfortunately, because I didn't run into the girl. I skipped her. Maybe it'll still be there. I don't know.
It used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy.
Oh yeah, Final Fantasy 15 as well coming out.
Yeah.
In November. Big time for video games.
Big time. Right before the holidays. December's gonna... Oh, have you done your Christmas shopping yet?
I have not.
Me neither.
I have not done my Christmas
but
shopping.
But I found out today, my sister needs winter boots, so I know what I'm getting her. Hopefully she's not watching this, because it's going to ruin the surprise.
You're getting her summer sandals.
Yeah. Haha, joke. Just a funny joke for Christmas. Merry Christmas! I don't know which is worse. Just take your pick. Who's your favorite character in Dishonored?
My favorite character in Dishonored...
You don't really get a sense of, like... Corvo's personality. I know he cares a lot about Emily and the Empress, but...
You know, the honest truth is that I didn't really feel connected to many characters in Dishonored. Like, they were just okay.
Yeah.
I think in terms of, like, being memorable, Granny Rags is a pretty memorable character. Especially with, like, the whole thing that you end up having to do with her, where she's, like, this witch who... Well, I don't want to spoil it for people. But,
who should definitely go back and play this, by the way.
She does some bad things to people, and you kind of have a choice of what you want to do with her. In fact, you'll actually get to meet Granny Rags, I think.
Hopefully in this stream. That'd be great.
Scusi.
She seems nice.
I would not judge her by her looks.
Well, she doesn't seem like she hates me or wants to kill me. Oh, is she going to kill herself? What are you doing, lady? Why are you looking down there?
You should steal from that lady.
You think I should?
I think you should steal from that lady.
She
has a shiny on her back.
I know, but I'm afraid that she's going to... It's not letting me
take
it.
Oh, what did she just do? She just stomped something.
Well, it's probably
from
a rat.
Lady. Steal from her.
She's letting me... I can't steal from her.
Try crouching.
Oh, maybe there. Yeah, you're right.
There we go. Okay, good job.
She didn't even notice. Wow, I'm really good. Damn. Corvo's such a great pitpocker. Pocket picker.
Pickpocket?
Pickpocket! That's the one I was looking for. I just had my coffee, guys. I just had it.
It's not even your knuckle mug.
Oh, God. I know. Is that guy there?
He's
that's what I need. My knuckle mug is... broke it. I don't know who broke it. That's the worst part. Left it in the kitchen, and then when I found it in the kitchen, it was like, oh, I know what I need to do here. Oh, right, that's right, you can possess rats! Does that mean you can possess flies in the next game? Ooh, that'd be cool. I mean, it'd be kind of gross.
I don't think you can possess the flies.
Oh, here you go. Da-da-da-da! That'd be cool, though, if you could. So did you actually get to play the Dishonored 2? Like, is there a demo?
I did not get to play it. No, I watched Damon play it. Or no, I watched the developers play it. Damon was hosting.
Okay, so you did get to see a lot of it.
Yeah.
See, I haven't even seen any of that.
I saw a good amount of it.
I should probably look that up.
It looked really cool.
Probably look that up. That would be awesome.
See, this is kind of like, this whole area right here, Clavering Boulevard, is like a summation of what I love about Dishonored. How there's so many different ways that you could have gotten through that. You could have gone around to the alley where you would have ran to Granny Rags. You could have taken out the whale oil tank to get rid of the wall of light. Or you could have just
climbed
over it.
Which I did.
It's such smart level design in terms of like all the different options that you have
to infiltrate. To assassinate. And yeah, I totally
and, like,
agree.
You can watch someone else play and they'll do it completely different than you and be like, oh my god, I gotta replay it now and try to do that too.
A lot of variety. Wait, are you saying that I miss Granny Rags?
Granny Rags is around to the other side, so that way, basically.
Oh, on the other side here?
Yeah. No, behind you.
This way?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll definitely meet her then. Let's make it a point to go say hi.
I'm pretty sure she's that way.
Okay. So, like, you can go into people's houses, and that's really sad. I don't want to see... Oh, blah, blah. The feels. Can't handle it. Okay, cool. Do you think she's, like, back here? Somewhere?
I think go as far as you can that way. And
almost
then
died.
Follow this path to the left.
This path?
No, not to the...
No.
Not there. That's,
this left
there
or that?
Okay,
right.
I think
there
up
she
there.
Is.
There
is
she
that
is.
Her?
That's her.
Yeah.
Granny Rags,
so
ladies
angry.
And gentlemen.
Oh. Hello. Oh, she disappeared. What? That's crazy.
Where did you go?
I don't know.
Yes, I would.
Nope. Oh, there she is.
Granny, granny, granny. Dear? Is
Ooh, she's spooky looking. Oh, she's blind.
My eyes aren't what they used to be.
Oh.
Have you seen my little birdie?
That's Susan for sure. Oh, yeah, that's her. That's
must
awesome.
Be starving without their granny. Here, birdies. Here.
So good.
Oh, my, my, my. I think I have gentlemen callers again, but not the way I used to, not the nice ones. I hear them, and they're not very polite ones either. Granny Rags, let us in.
This is a great scene.
They'll go away again if they know what's good for them. But what a bother. Here's the key to the front door, love.
Yes.
You'll see to those ruffians, won't you?
Yes, gladly.
Oh,
all right.
You're getting taken in by Granny Rags, Naomi. Don't let her trick you. She's not a good person.
But I like her.
She's not as helpless as she seems.
Yeah, she's looks a little bit like a witch. Not to be mean or anything. Oh my god. She's got a urn in her house. Also, sleep darts. Yes! I love these. Oh, I'm full of sleep darts I can't handle anymore. I still have to get... I don't have my, Oh, shoot. These
Would
guys
you
are...
look at this? You don't walk in a bottle. Be looking like that. That outfit must have cost a lot. Maybe I'll let my girlfriend wear it. Come on! Let's go!
That
oh,
what? They have. They can breathe fire?
They can breathe fire. Oh!
I think I kind of panicked there.
Yeah, you were taken aback by the fire breathing.
It took me a while to process that. Like, what? They can. Oh, I don't know. Oh, I probably did save. Auto-saved.
Yeah, this
part. Good. Thank goodness, because I haven't been saving at all. Just relying on the auto-saves. I know. It's a bad habit of mine. Oh, did she give me the key? Yeah, she did. Should I just straight up kill them? You don't
walk in a box. I'm gonna leave it to you.
Let me just set myself up with my gun.
Boom!
Oh, two! Almost. There's no way to avoid that. Oh, stop it! I know, I need to...
Bok.
There you go. We're good. They're mean. But, is she gonna be nice to me or, like, try to kill me now? Oh, she's...
Oh, my dear. I knew you'd help me with those ill-mannered boys. My brave...
They were pretty rude.
Listen.
They spat fire at me. That's, like, pretty rude in my book.
I got it from the outsider, and now I'm giving it to you.
Oh, she knows the outsider.
It's upstairs.
This can't be good.
On the vanity. I think you'll cut a nice figure with it. Remember how we used to dance? Our parties were even grander than those at the Boyle Manor. Everyone wanted to
She looks like an apparition. As she, like, she kind of, her arm kind of went through the wall there.
I don't remember her. I remember, like, she has a good backstory. But I don't remember exactly what it was. I want to say that she and the outsider were in some sort of relationship, but I don't quite remember.
I hope you like the little gift I got for you. It's the least I could do for turning those louts away.
Thank you.
I can't bear these Bottle Street children. Ruffians, every last one of them.
People are asking for subtitles. So
oh, that's right.
I feel like we did it at the beginning, but did we not go through with, like... Did it not save or something?
I don't think we did it. I think I told you that let's remember to do that.
Oh.
And then we never did.
Bad Mitchell.
No, it was me. It was me. For sure. Main dialogue only, I guess, is fine.
Sure.
We don't need to do more than that.
Sorry, guys. This is for you.
We fixed it. Give you another present. What are we, like halfway through the stream now?
Yeah.
Not
this
bad.
Has been flying.
It's been flying, yeah. Actually, the one that flew the most, though, was... Monday, yeah, when I was playing Outlast. That flew by, thankfully, because that game is scary. Did you ever put together that piece of all my jump scares?
Yes, I did.
Awesome. So guys, go look for that on YouTube, I think. Is it on YouTube?
It should be on YouTube.
Okay.
See to it, dear. I'll find you another present just like the first.
Yes, more runes.
Galvani lives on Clavering Boulevard.
Oh.
Or at least you gotta do something for her first. You don't just get free runes.
I know. Now she's good at getting me to do stuff. Damn it. Damn it, Granny Rags. Damn it. So. Okay, let's do it. Let's go. So, Dr. Galvin's office, is that where I need to go? No, the Wall of Light? You'll have to go or they won't come. Which one is it? Oh, it's in the. The doctor one, right?
Yeah, I wasn't actually paying attention.
Yeah, me neither.
I think
the
Wall of Light, going through the Wall of Light is to continue on with the main mission.
It's the main mission, yeah. Whereas, I'm not so sure. I know this is probably not the right way, but let's go. Yeah, because there's like, it's basically getting back to where I was originally.
And once again, guys, as always, you can tweet your questions at IGN using the hashtag IGNPlaysLive. Let me go check that hashtag out right now.
Checking the hashtag.
And we got a question, so hold on one second. Oh, God, I got to do that in order. So Roy Gnott, or Roy4114 on Twitter asked, as someone who's never played Dishonored, what are your favorite features that are different in some ways from other first-person shooter games? I'll let you have that one first.
I think the variety is one of the biggest things for me. Like, you're not... relying on machine guns, you really have to go about each mission differently. Or you can, which I like having that option. I think that's different. Yeah, it's not like a Battlefield 1 or Call of Duty. It's more along the lines of how Portal did it, but with a bit more killing. those are my thoughts on it, I think. That about sums it up. What about you, Mitchell?
Hold on one sec. We got people saying, use the heart, or some people are clamoring for the heart.
But
I guess there might be something nearby, but...
Oh, yeah, this guy.
But yeah, so, I mean, talking about it in terms of other first-person shooters, I feel like is not really helpful because Dishonored is nothing like a regular first-person shooter. Like, again, the best comparison for it is to something like Thief or Deus Ex in terms of, like, being more of an RPG and stealth game than a shooter.
Yeah.
Because there are shooter elements. You have a gun, obviously, but the gun is very much like it locks on to people. You don't really have to worry about precision aiming. You don't
there you go.
Really have to worry about taking cover. So yeah, oh, there's your rune.
She's gonna steal it from her while she's holding it.
Be careful, Cole.
Yay. Thanks for reminding me to use the heart, guys. You wouldn't recognize. Yeah, I agree with you, Mitchell. Or even the name of her fan. 100% agree with you.
Yeah, so like begged for her hand. I still recommend, even if you're a shooter fan, like give it a shot, but definitely don't give it a shot because you like shooters. It's not the same kind of, you know, game.
It's a lot different. Measure their worth and find them wanting.
Then she made a different choice.
It's a little Bioshocky.
You're on your way to face the High Overseer, the leader of a great cult dedicated to loathing me. What will you do, I wonder?
Ooh.
What will you do?
Yeah, I don't know. Alright, cool, so. Where are we going? Where are we going, people? So, we should start with the Galvani's offices, which, gotta figure out how to get to in the best way possible. Should I just take these guys out? I feel like they're gonna be a problem. If I
take them out.
Should I just go stealth?
They're bad men.
Cross the line and have your throat cut.
Oh, he's threatening you now.
Yeah, should I just go out?
I think that should have put you over the edge. Oop.
Somebody, give me a hand. Oh, like they have fire!
You should have started with the stab to the neck.
How would I have done that?
No,
I don't think I've ever done that.
Saying,
oh, God.
Corvo should have known to start with the stab to the neck.
Well,
not just a wimpy slash.
It just went into his shoulder and didn't do anything. I don't know how to take them out. I'm a little... Maybe just if I have bullets. I don't know if I'm out of bullets, actually. Yeah, I am. Or maybe just sleep dart.
Yeah, you got a ton of sleep darts.
I'm going to use them sleep darts. How about that?
Put them to sleep.
Yep.
Give him the GTS. Sal on Twitter, echo echo 311, wants me to let you know that he sent you a tweet of a link from Amazon of your knuckle mug.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Good. Okay, well, I still got burnt here, but I'm still alive because they're all passed out and I wasted a dart. He sent me a tweet about my mug.
It's an Amazon link with your mug.
But is it the company? Like, I don't know. I think there's like some imitations out there. But I'll check it. Definitely we'll check it. Cool. So I have to go there. That's going to be interesting.
There's a guy that's trapped that you're ignoring his pleas for help.
Where?
It's like, let me out. Let me out.
Is
I'm
he
trapped.
Down there? Yeah. Okay. He's help. The one I saved him. I saved him from the guards. Okay. I'm going to go. Just want to make sure this guy doesn't see me. Let's go stealth.
Don't worry, guy. She's not ignoring you.
I mean, sort of was, but it's okay now. Your help has guided me.
I'm trapped.
Not
I'm
anymore.
Trapped.
Not anymore, buddy. Thanks, brother. Oh yeah, he's the guy with the shop.
I wouldn't want my face seen either, pulling a stunt like that. You know what? I'll return the favor. Come by Griff's shop.
That's my business.
Well. It was.
It's not really.
But now I'm reduced to scavenging things from here and there as the city dies. If you need anything, I wouldn't mind trading for a little money.
I think he has more sleep darts I can
blow
use.
Over and everything will go back to normal. But until then, it's scavenging for me.
Awesome. Awesome. Oh, sorry. Okay. I'll let you out first. Huh? Awkward. Money, 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 money. Okay. There was some other stuff in here. I feel like there's beating heart. I'm sensing. Oh, it's there though. That's that kind of far. There's another rune over there. Crazy. I feel like that far. Oh, that's like on the other side, isn't it? But that's strange. That looks like exactly where I was earlier. When I went to see Granny Rags. Could be wrong. Yeah, that looks like it. Strange. She just keep.
Sorry for my silence. I'm just checking, checking chat.
Here, birdies. Why the heck would it? Is it because I died? Probably did. Skip that.
Be careful, Corvo. You're on your way to face.
Cool. I should probably set up my powers, actually, now that I think about it. Cool. Bloodthirsty. What's that? Oh, melee fatalities. Possession?
Possession's
fun.
Which
is pretty cool, yeah. But I can't get it just yet. I can get Bloodthirsty, which... Or I should upgrade Dark Vision a little bit. Actually, that might be cool. What does it do? Oh, yeah, level 2, you can see through. Yeah. I like that. Cool.
When I played this game, I went immediately to bumping up Blink as much as I could because... I love going like on the top path, and whenever I like see a path but can't get to it, it drives me crazy. So I immediately make a decision early on, like I have to be able to go
a
along
farther,
all the paths.
Yeah. And Blink helps with that immensely. Oh
yeah.
My god. I freaking love that power. Huh? Oh, you didn't see me. Ba-dum. Oh shucks.
I love that noise that it makes when you get spotted.
Sleep dart. He didn't. He hadn't fully seen me, and now he definitely sees me. There it goes. Nope. Okay. Usually they live a pouch. Oh god. Okay, I'm out of. Am I out of darts? No. There goes that guy. Okay, wait. Probably shouldn't. What? Another one.
The sleep darts take too long.
They do take long. Man. I guess they're all out now, so that's good.
I just love how we've come to accept the video game logic of if you see a sleep dart hit you, it takes longer to act than if you didn't see it.
Hashtag video game logic.
Hashtag video games.
All right, so. I said I'd go in stealth this time, but I have not been doing any of that. I'm just gonna try
all
to
right, well,
survive.
How about this? Let's make this the challenge. This area, I want you to go through it as
full stealth.
All right.
Okay.
Unfortunately, I told you that when you've already used all your sleep darts.
Yep.
But.
And I should just go buy some more. Before entering here, I should have gotten to my friend who had this shop, so I could. Oh, there's some sleep darts in there actually. Check it out.
What would Solid
or
Snake
somewhere.
Do, Naomi?
Go inside a box.
All right, well,
there's
you can't do
darts.
That.
Oh, were those sleeping bolts?
I think you'd probably sneak up behind these guys and stab them in the neck.
Damn, you're brutal. Stab them? Like,
stab
don't em. Put them to sleep? Just
well, okay, you can put them to sleep. Oh!
It's okay, you didn't see me.
I mean, my solid snake likes to slit throats.
Whoops! My bad.
So many whoops.
Yeah. I wasted a bullet and a... Sorry, sleeping dart. Oh, it's okay. He's fine. See you right here.
Suck jaw.
I can't pick him? What? I'm out of ammo.
You have too much ammo for the crossbow.
Oh, but not the actual ammo that I want, which is the sleep darts. Whatever. Should I just go through here? See if I can check in to see if there's anybody? No. Good.
All right, so far so good.
Doing all right. Oh, they're far away. They can't see me. Should I go in here?
I like
there's a lot of rats.
I like when Naomi goes into stealth mode. She talks really quietly.
Yeah.
so that the guards can't hear her through the game.
It's an immersive experience.
I gotcha. I'm the same way.
Go all quiet. Like I was playing Outlast, that was a quiet stream.
Yeah.
That was the quietest stream you'll ever see. Okay. I'm not sure if I'm...
Looks like you need to
go
upstairs.
Looks like he's upstairs, yeah. But there might be some useful stuff here that I could use, like sleep darts. Keys, yes.
Need those.
Always need those. There's some rats in there for whatever reason. Okay, looks like I'm good for this. Cool. They're looking away.
Okay. All right, got two guys up there, or guy and lady. Dr. Galvani's lab? Yeah,
I think so. Oh, it got really dark for a second.
Then you have to scrub. The rats get their vital essences everywhere, the doctor said.
Do you think I can, like, blink up there?
I think you might even be able to jump up there, but...
But I'm afraid. Okay, maybe I'll try.
Go for it. right, you got it.
Can't we just... No, I told God, it feels so cool infiltrating these. With alcohol or white vinegar.
All right, all right. What is he doing there all day? Ambrose says he breathes rats.
Think he's in here? Oh, no, he's up another floor, I think.
I think he might be on the third floor. And once again, like, a cool thing about this is, like, you could avoid this whole thing of going from the bottom floor and up if you just, on the outside, you can get onto the balcony and just get right into the third floor.
Yeah.
But you need to have, you probably need to have, like, an upgrade blink in order to do that.
Okay, they're kind of just hanging there. Because I can maybe, oh, God.
You're good, you're good.
But, okay, he's coming in here, though. Or it looks like it. Oh, no, she is. Oh, no. Am I going to have to sleep dart her?
Look around the room. There might be, like, a secret passage or something in here that you can use to get into the other room. Nope, maybe not.
A vent or something?
Oh, you can sleep dart her. Nice.
There you go.
She has a key.
Oop, sorry.
Whoops.
Wanted to get out of that. Thought I was in my, my dark vision mode. But I was not.
Abstract is like, this is genuinely suspenseful.
It's really suspenseful, I know. Okay, so he's gone, so... But I want to go up, right?
You want to go up.
Let's see here. Where's he at? Where's that guy? Did he just go upstairs?
He might have gone upstairs.
Yeah, it seemed like he was heading that direction earlier. So let's do this. And hopefully... Oh, God.
There he is. Okay.
He's
looking the other
way.
He's
looking the other way.
Looking the other way. Go!
Go.
Go. Uh-oh.
Nope. Okay, I thought I had the key.
All right, just take this guy out. Stealth until stealth fails.
Oh, God.
Nice. All right, I think I was the only guy.
I really wish I had... Oh, I do. Yes. Oh, no. Cool. So, cleaning instructions.
Important.
Very important. Okay, so we have made it to this part. Is there anyone else? No, we're good. So, what is the thing I'm supposed to do? I mean, I'm going to steal some stuff, for sure. Looks like empty bottles. What's this thing? Ew! There's a lot of gross stuff in this game. A lot of weird, gross things that I don't like. I need some bread. Just reading stuff. Yes! Key and another key! I love keys! I can't believe I don't think I did this mission when I played it the first time. God, I failed. So I want to go back and... Oh, what's this? That's just money? Yeah, not useful. But I think I saw a dart somewhere. Probably not.
Okay. So I'm just going to really quick go through a couple of tweets that we got. Will Dishonored 2, or... So this is from Shadow Dark Knife. That says, will Dishonored 2 have add-ons like the Knife of Dunwall? I don't think we really have the answers to that question. I would imagine yes, because it's a AAA game, and AAA games like to do DLCs. We got, do you think the second Dishonored would be better than the first? That's the hope, right?
Yeah.
I think it will be. I think there's a lot of stuff that could be improved on Dishonored, even though a lot of it is really good, but they can just go further with it. I don't know if you have any thoughts on that, Naomi.
Yeah, I think I...
Do you think the second... Do you think the sequel's going to be better than the first?
From the story, like, just reading what the story will be like, which is basically just Emily's going to try to regain her... Or steal back her throne. Which, to me, just sounds like, oh, that's cool, but... There's nothing like a murder mystery going on here, like, in the second game, it seems like, which I like in a game. Oh, what? I don't have the key to open it? Yes, I do. Ha ha. Where is this rat? Did I grab the thing I was supposed to in there? Nope. Oh, is it in... Oh, do... So I was wondering, is this a vent that I can go into
eventually? So if you possess a rat,
I don't
the rat
have.
Can go in there.
I don't have that power yet, unless... Did I get anything? No.
There's probably another way in there.
Let's see what there is. Yeah. Oh, it might have been in that room.
The bookcase. I mean, you know, whenever you look at a bookcase, you gotta look for a special book.
Really?
Special books. Uh-huh. There we go.
Secret door unlocked. Woohoo! Ah, you were correct. We got it. So this is a yuck. A bunch of money. Yes, please. I'll take that.
And then we also have a question from Fang the Dog on Twitter. What upcoming games are you looking forward to? Which
I
feel like
we touched on it a little bit.
We answer this question probably every Naomi plays.
Yeah.
Really quick, Last Guardian, Watch Dogs 2. What else?
Sonic 2,
obviously. Final Fantasy 15.
Okay, I have to get out of here now.
Someone was asking me why I'm not on camera. Just because this is Naomi Plays. I feel like it should be Naomi on camera. And there's also stuff that I need to do on the producer board, so...
He's handling those lower thirds and everything going on in the stream.
Every time I want to be like, hey guys, you can tweet your questions at us using the hashtag IGNPlaysLive. See, this is all me doing that stuff.
Yep.
Unless I mess up. Unless someone messes up, then it's not me.
Oh god, three guys. No! This is really hard doing it on the stairs. Oh gosh. I'm just gonna parry them. They're still coming after me, though. Whoops, my timing was off on that. Oh, again!
Oh, God. You have any grenades?
I probably do. There you go. Come on. That timing was so bad. It's all good, though. I'm low health. Probably gonna die at this point. Should I save? This would be a bad part to save, huh?
You got no more health?
Yeah. Whatever, they're all dead. All that matters is that I'm going back to meet up with Granny Rags, and I'm excited about that. Hopefully she's nice to me again. Until she's not, and then I'm going to have to kill her. Cool. So that didn't go as stealthily as it was supposed to, right?
It started out great.
It was so great at the start. And then I failed. Okay, I'm gonna go down here because I'm afraid I'm gonna kill myself. I have so low health right now. Let me eat some kebabs. Some really cool. Oh, do I have to go to the distillery? I hope not. Is that part of the plan? No, don't make me go in the distillery. Okay, fine. Yes. So what's going on, people? What's going on? It's 2:24 here.
Just blowing right through the stream.
Just blowing right through it. So it's a very hostile zone, and I'm at zero health, which is not great.
For the people that say that we don't look at the YouTube chat, we totally do. It's just there's not often, like, I'm trying to find stuff that I can say. A lot of stuff I can't really... there's no discussion that comes forward from it.
Oh, he does not like me. So I can't... I have to sneak in here somehow. Let's go through... Yeah, let's go up there. Okay, let's figure this out here. Gotta get there. This is so cool. I love being able to use this power. That's one of the... See, they're not even going to see that I'm... Well, except I triggered their... Face like a hagfish. They did see me a little bit. Don't be sour.
Damn it. Say, all right, I'm going to pose a hypothetical question to you, Naomi.
Go right ahead.
You can only buy one. This the idea from this comes from on Twitter, at Mac DaCosta. You can only choose one.
Yes.
Would you pick Watch Dogs 2... or Dishonored 2?
I'm gonna go with... Oh, they left. I was gonna distract them. So let's just try that. I'm gonna go with Dishonored 2.
Dishonored 2. Wow, even though Watch Dogs 2 takes place in San Francisco, your home...
I know!
Your backyard?
Well, so I played the demo and I got to see... a bit of San Francisco. It would have been cool to explore, like, Silicon Valley and Oakland and all that, but I don't know. Like, I played Dishonored 1 to completion. I have, like, such an attachment to it that it wouldn't be fair not to play the second one, right?
Yeah, I mean, I'm on board with you. I also would say Dishonored 2.
There you go. See?
Watch out for the trap.
Should I just go under it?
You can slide under it. You want to slide under it?
I don't know. I don't want to alert anybody, but...
I think you can do it.
Okay.
Boosh!
It still triggered it?
It still triggered it.
With my knife? What happened? I'm so dying. I'm so dying, guys. And I didn't save. This is really bad.
I think it probably auto-saved when he came in.
Oh, okay. So might as well just die and get my health back up.
That's on me. That's on me. I'll take credit for that death.
I don't know why it still triggered it. Was it because I had my knife out? That seemed like it shouldn't have happened.
It shouldn't have happened.
I slid for a long time, okay?
They even taught you in the beginning of the game that you could slide under traps like that.
Yeah. Maybe I should just use my power up here. Nope, that did not do it either. So apparently if you blink, you're still... Yeah, I'm going to die. It's fine. I tried to blink on the other side, and it doesn't work where you teleport. It's more like... You just move quickly. You become the Flash for a second. So that didn't work either. Oh, man. Oh, he's totally going to see me.
So, yeah, to go back to that question, I personally think Dishonored 2, just because even though I'm excited for Watch Dogs 2, I did not have a great opinion of the first game. It was just, you know, it was flawed.
So oh, does it.
Doesn't work.
Every time. There's always the runaway option. Oh, except that there's a lot of baddies here.
Oh, there's so many baddies.
There's so many baddies. I'd rather just die and restart. How can I get through there if you can't? I don't have the key. Maybe I have to find the key to the distillery. That gated area. Okay. I'm going to try this one more time.
I would say take a look above and see if there's a way to get...
Like teleport up here?
Yeah, see if there's a way to get through that without going through the trap. It doesn't look like there is.
Yeah.
I mean, so you can go on top of that little railing over there?
Which one?
To the right? The railing to the right?
This thing?
On the ground? To the left.
What?
There you go.
This thing?
Just on top of that, yeah. You should be able to jump on that without triggering.
Oh, just jump down. Yeah, that's another thing I could do. I just don't want anyone seeing me, which... Like they don't.
There we go.
Okay, well, thank you for that.
No problem.
Now it's just about deciding how to go about this. Oh man, he's gonna see me. Maybe he won't. He straight up does not see me. That's
so
amazing.
Not to the Abbey or the office of the High.
My health is still super low.
Where they train the
Where should I? I'm trying to get this guy to find out.
He just wants to know where it's
oh, God.
Whoop.
Sneaks it. You know Eddie. Throw it at him when he's sober.
Damn. Oh, turns around so fast.
I think he's good. He's Oh, no, you're not.
Okay. Maybe if I follow him? He definitely has to go down. I feel like.
Stab him in the neck.
I'm trying to do this stealth, man.
You can be
so
stealthy.
So far I haven't.
Even while stabbing people in the necks, I'm just saying.
But the more people I kill, the more the rats come out, and it's not.
Naomi, I have a quota for number of people that need to be stabbed in the neck during the stream.
You do?
I do.
Thanks for telling me about it.
Destin's gonna be on my butt.
I'm not gonna get this quota then. Oh
god. Oh god.
He totally saw me. No stabbing in the neck this time. Oh no, not the fire. That's okay. Let's restart it anyway. All right, so jump down that railing and then figure out a way to take him out and stab him in the neck.
Stab him
in the
neck.
Because apparently Mitchell has a quota. Thanks, Destin. All right. Just wait till he turns around. Yeah, see, now I'm dead. Now I'm dead. Now it's for sure going down. Maybe if he runs up here, he'll blow up.
Oh, he seemed to not really care.
Oh, okay.
Oh, nope, he cares.
No, he's going down.
Oh,
going
no,
downstairs.
He doesn't.
Yeah, that's weird. They've been alerted. They know I'm there. They're probably just on high alert. They're trying to scout the area to see where I am because they can't find me.
Someone's about to get shanked.
Someone's about to get shanked. See, even they need people get stabbed in the neck.
I was in stealth mode, dude. How'd you see me? Yeah. Well, you want to come up? Set off the trigger.
Whoop.
Okay. He's bad news.
How smart are they?
He's bad news bears. Whoa! okay. Shouldn't have, they're really strong. Yes. They get me out in one hit. Well, I'm also low health. There's that. Forgot that that was part of the quick save that I got. Damn it. I should have found more food or something.
I would also say that I'm pretty sure this is still like a side quest, so.
I know, but like, this is part of the,
Is this still part of the Granny Rags thing?
Yeah, I think so. Because there was no follow-up to when I went to see, what's his name in the office.
All right, this is, I think this is the Slackjaw mission, isn't it?
I'm not sure. Maybe I can not. Check. When I oversee Campbell, I haven't done the Wall of Light part yet. This yeah. is, oh wait, let's scroll down here. This is Gentleman Callers, Contaminate the Battle Street Gang's Bootleg Elixir with Plague. Is this okay. part of the distillery, I guess? Yeah. I don't know.
All right, it's still a side mission, but yeah, let's do it.
Wait. Oh, I see. Wait. Mission items. Mission clues, perhaps? No, that's all for the main stuff. Let's, wait till he turns around, and then... Hello. What the hell, dude? Jump! What are you doing? There you go. Took a while. This is really bad. I have no health to get past this.
Don't forget about your blink.
Yeah.
So you can blink from cover to cover.
That's true. I could just do this. Okay, don't catch me. Don't catch me. Okay, except that he's going to come here and then see me. Okay, wait. Okay, we're getting the hang of it. Except how am I going to distract these guys? Is there a bottle I can pick up somewhere?
I would say, so there's a couple of options. You can try to go up those stairs, or you can try to climb the chain that's to the right.
Didn't see the chain. Where's it at?
So it's behind the, to the left right there.
Oh,
right
there. Yeah. Except, okay. Oops, I got out of stealth mode, and that was a mistake. Okay, they totally got me.
I don't think you're gonna make it.
I'm not gonna make it. I really need more help. This is bad. This is the type of situations you can get in with Dishonored. Okay, I'm gonna try one more time. But yeah, definitely go. Okay, I'm gonna try the chain. Try climbing up the chain in stealth mode. Hopefully nobody sees me. I can maybe do it with this one.
You can. Yeah, you can also climb that chain right there.
But getting there's, well, aw, shucks, you're kidding me. I'm just gonna blow myself up. That did nothing.
Not with that attitude, you're not.
Just do it already. I can also just load, but I've died so many times. This is not going well. Should have saved when I had health.
Cobra Commander wants you to know that going in via the pipes in the whiskey distillery is stealthier. So
up here, right?
I would imagine.
Aw, man.
Yeah, you can use those pipes.
I'm going to try to use the pipes. Gonna reload here real fast. But I can't climb the pipes. I have to teleport up there.
You can teleport up there.
Ooh, maybe with my... See, I don't know how you... My, let's see here. Pick up here. Nope. How do you cancel?
X.
Just X?
Yeah.
Okay, not that. Just turn around. They're super on high alert. They're like, watchdog.
Make up. Be careful, that guy's looking.
There you go. Where they train the
overseers to be real religious. All right, okay. I think you're good.
He just wants to know where his brother is. There you go.
You want the pipes? Sneaks in. You know Eddie. Brilliant at it when he's sober. All right. I remember. Another blink. Hidden the
dumbwaiter all night. I just want to make sure. Wait, am I even going the right way? I think
nope, you're going the right way.
Okay, so I gotta get to this guy. Oh, the door. Stuff you'd expect, but it gets weird. Some kind of machinery. I make sure I'm around. Come on. Maybe that'll work. Yes, it does. Oh,
oh God!
No!
No!
No! All right, hold up. Oh my God, how did I survive that? Okay, wait, he was not dead? Man, these guys are really strong. Maybe I should be playing on easy. Karen, try that one more time. But we definitely know where we need to go next, which is nice. I'm definitely going to save once I'm on those pipes next, so we don't have to keep going through this part. It's one of the most important things is, like, save all the time. Why is he just hanging out there? Okay, he's going to come back. Try this again. Yeah, it's fine.
So it goes, not to the Abbey or the office of the
High Overseer. How do they not see this?
Where they train the overseers to be real religious.
Ah, man.
Crazy.
Here we go. Stop doing that! it's like you have to have your camera up or else it brings you back down. Okay. Alright, we're saving. Because I'm not going through that again. Woo-hoo. What? I saved right when he notices me? Okay, hold up.
I think you're fine. He didn't go full alert. Aw, Pelagius said, Naomi has such a bright personality that stealthing is literally impossible.
Ah! I'm gonna load again. It's hard to get it, like, right on the perfect part of the... Aw, what? Don't tell me I saved
here.
Oh, no. Don't tell me this is happening. Ugh, it should be way easier. Yeah, see, they get it. Aw, man, like, really? Okay, maybe I can, nope. There's gotta be a way to do this. Just don't notice me right away, please.
Brimsley job, hitting the dumbwaiter all night. Yeah, so he goes from room to room, kids sleeping, and over here giving a lecture to the kids.
How do I get this guy out?
So you can shoot an arrow at him.
Make
that
sure
should be quiet enough.
Okay. Oops, that's the knife. Oh, yeah.
There you go. Oh, he's not dead.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, it took an extra hit, I think, for this guy when he started blowing fire at me earlier. Okay. Man, it's high security up here. Okay, should I save? I think so. I think it's a good time to save.
Get rid of that awful save where you saved right when they started to seeing you.
Yeah, or so low health that I had nothing going on here. Which right now, oh no, that's not what I need, brah. I need some health.
Huh?
What? Who's there?
He probably saw the dead body over there.
Oh yeah. Well, no, actually. Maybe he's down there somewhere.
Playing a kill everyone or no kill game? I think somewhere in the middle.
It's pretty heavy in the kills.
Pretty heavy in the kills.
Whoa.
Oh, there you go.
I'm gonna use my
Oh, headshot, nice.
Got him good. See, we're pretty heavy on the kill side.
No, pretty high chaos cool. Right now.
Oh no, I need a key. Does he have it? Why would he have it? Of course. Why would it be so easy that he had it? Give me some health. I need health. Damn it. Oh, I don't really need that right now.
Who needs the magic?
Oh,
that's a trap.
Good thing I saw that. I'm just going to jump over it, right? Our luck hasn't been that good, so.
Definitely don't try to slide under it.
Save right here, though. So we're good.
There you go.
Did it. Okay, but he has the master key, whoever's in there. Let's see what's going on.
Okay. Here you go.
I think this is just back at the
main
room.
Oh, really? Man. So how do I get in there? Maybe there's gotta run and jump. Oh. No. That would have been the way to go.
You
can
just crouch through there.
Never mind. Wish I'd seen that earlier. Yeah.
Yep.
Oh my god. Granny Rags is gonna be so proud of me. She's gonna be so proud of me. Okay, cool. Oh, what? What is this? Don't need that. Anything else? Cool. It's like, we're good. Now I just gotta get out of here without being seen again. Which may or may not happen.
And you have health now.
I know! Okay, I'm gonna save. Sure to save all the time. What time is it?
It is 2:41.
Oh my god! We only got 20 minutes left! I'm freaking out!
It's the final countdown.
Sorry, once you start singing, it's gonna be, Oh, I could maybe teleport.
The fuck are you looking at?
Blow off the chopper. Whoa. Language, dude. Maybe if I jump and, you think I could do it from here? Looks like a risk I'm not willing to take.
So,
do you
someone
think I could run and jump onto this thing, onto the chain, and get over here? Do you think I can make it to here? I think I can. Okay. Make sure to do this right. Jump, and then let go. Yes!
Yeah.
Woo!
Look at these advanced techniques.
Oh my god, I'm so pro. I'm a Dishonored master. I don't know what's in here, but
someone was actually telling us on Twitter that so that empty vial that you threw, you could actually, before you poisoned the distillery, you can actually use that to get yourself health.
What? Man. Then I could have just used it from... Yeah. Well, I poisoned the distillery pre-getting that thing, so... Too bad.
Too bad.
Too bad.
Oh, there's that key that you could have used.
Well, that would have been handy earlier. Okay, so I guess I can just... get out from here and avoid
you
getting
did it.
Blown up!
You did it!
I done it! All right, I'm saving.
You done did it, Naomi.
I done did it. Cool, so hopefully we can finish this and get to the assassination part, but I don't think we'll have time, unfortunately. Because the assassination of the officer is a little tougher. Actually, this might have been the hardest part I've played so far today. Oh, show. I don't need that! No! Cool. Oh god.
Uh-oh.
It's okay, I got it. Alright. And now we're on our way out. Back to the witch.
Someone was asking how often Naomi streams. Naomi streams at least once a week.
Yep. And this week we did an extra stream on Monday because it was Halloween.
Halloween.
Don't you feel like Halloween was so far away now that it's November?
Basically eternity ago.
Don't need that either. All right. Hopefully he isn't there. And we're fine. We are out.
And also, I guess we can talk about it because it's going to be happening soon, but you're going to be having your own horror series that you're going to be doing.
Yes. So
Let's
that's
Play
officially
series.
Happening now, right?
It's officially happening.
Yeah.
It is now on me to make it happen.
Well, you've been pretty awesome. So
oh, thank
I
you.
Don't doubt that you're going to be able to pull it off.
But yeah, so we're going to have a horror live stream, or not live stream, it's going to be a Let's Play series with Naomi.
Yeah, so get ready for a lot of jump scares, people. It's going to be frightening. But yeah, I'm excited for that. Let me talk to you, girl.
I knew you wouldn't disappoint me.
Of course not. Along the waterfront and I bet now I have to kill her, right?
not right now.
Oh, okay. Thank you. I'm gonna steal some darts. I always need them. Cool. So we are all set to go and continue the main mission, which hopefully we have some time to get at least somewhat farther along here. Progress through the game. Well, I killed all the guys in here, so that's nice. Oh, wait, maybe not that guy though. Save here. Yes, please. Just in case I die. Since that happened a lot. And take this guy. Oh.
One of my favorite things to do is, so I think the enemies are able to pass through the wall of light, but you can actually rewire the controls so it makes it so that enemies can't walk through it.
Really?
And so you basically rewire it, you trigger an alarm, they all come through the wall and just get vaporized. That's one of my favorite things to do in
Dishonored.
So
let's try to do that.
You want
to
do that?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. Do you have a rewire tool?
Well, let's check if we have that first. I don't think I do.
Can you craft one?
Perhaps, yeah. Let's check. Whoops, wrong one. Let's go into inventory, perhaps? Is that where to do it? Yeah, gadgets. know.
I don't know if you doesn't can make it.
Doesn't look like I do it. That would have been so fun.
Could
have
Too bad.
Some bad guys, and it would have just been an accident. I would have just been like, sorry.
Whoops.
Whoops. Well, in that case, we'll Stupid goddamn. We'll just go about it the I'm gonna take some guys out slowly but surely. I don't know how I'm gonna take these two out though.
You can try. Kind of you can try a spring razor.
Oh yeah. No, no, don't come here.
I love how they whistle. What would you do with the drunken sailor?
Okay, they're gonna see me. They totally saw me. I'm not here. I'm just an illusion. Oh, it's that guy down there. Okay, I can take him out. Oh, what are you doing? That was a weird thing that happened. Spring razor, like somewhere around here or something.
Edubs on YouTube was asking who the guy is talking. That's me.
Hi. Yeah, Mitchell.
Hi, my name is Mitchell. I'm the live stream guy
Jurassic
here at
Rabbit.
IGN. At Jurassic Rabbit on Twitter. I'm glad that you mentioned that, because if I do it, it's like I'm shamelessly plugging stuff. But if you mention it first, why thank you.
All right,
oh, stab him in the neck!
No!
Or just choke him.
Or just choke him.
You know what?
I'll stab the next guy, I promise. I know there's a quota, so this is important. Oh, did he see
two
me?
Two strangles equals yeah. one stab in
the
neck,
set off
so.
The alarm. Shoot. Well, where's the other guy now? Did he just run in there? Okay, well. Oh, okay, they're all coming through.
See, yeah, if you could have rewired that control panel, they would have all been vaporized.
I'm actually gonna, I think I wanna die and or reload this, so I can try to get some stabs in. What do you think?
You know what? That will really help me out.
I'm going to stab some folks for you. Well, they're going out. They're going to die. It's going to be bad. Hope you're ready. Maybe if I could just go in. I mean, there's that guy on the other side who just never turns around, and he's really annoying.
Thank Come you, Pill. You're right. In Dishonored, it's actually what would you do with a drunken whaler? Not drunken sailor.
That's true. Did some little sliding action here. Maybe I can. He's not gonna see me, right? Oh, that's close. I can climb up here, right? I feel like. There's gotta be a way, yeah. Nice. Because they can't see me up here, I think. Ooh, drop assassination tutorial.
Ooh, get it.
How do I do it?
So you just jump on them.
Is it just the B?
I think if you just jump on them and press your.
My
stab button.
Yeah, my stab button. Okay, so. Well, he went away, so I can't really do it anymore. Okay, let's see if I can. Stop moving. Okay, he's gonna come back here, and then I'm gonna get him. I can get this guy.
Stab him in the neck, stab him in the neck, stab him in the neck.
Maybe he's gonna turn
around. You got this. How longer do I have?
Okay.
Get him while he's adjusting himself.
All right. Oh, I did the wrong thing.
Oh, oh God.
He got me. It was the R2 I should have done. Let's restart it. I really want to get those stabs in, so I'm going to get this right.
Well,
okay.
Is it on?
So he's going to come around here. I'll be prepared for him when he does. And hopefully no one sees me. Oh, maybe they just... No, they haven't changed their pattern, thankfully. I'm so used to just putting them to sleep. Okay, come on. Where are they at?
So yeah, while...
What? Just one of them.
While we try to get these guys stabbed in the neck...
Yes.
Let's just sum up. So what are you hoping for in Dishonored 2? Are you pretty much just hoping for
more
of the same.
Yeah, more of the same. I mean, I really like the new powers that they showed at the for the gameplay trailer, so I want to see, you know, how I can go about using those and having more fun doing different things. Or if I were to say, like, my real hope is that the story is really interesting. Mm-hmm. I think they did a good job with this one. I don't know if it's going to be as intriguing from, like, the synopsis I read, but I don't know, I have high hopes that they're able to pull it off. Another really good kind of interesting mystery or story going on in the world. And just to see the new environment that they created. This is very, like, mid-century London-esque. So I feel like if they can pull off a... what is it, like a Mediterranean kind of coast? It's more tropical, I feel like.
Ooh, get him! There you go. All right, ding.
Ding. That's one. How many do you need? What's your quota?
You know what? Let's go 15. Let's go for 10.
Okay. Well,
10 neck stabs. I feel like we already have like 5, but
we have nine minutes.
Get as many
out.
As you can.
Okay. But that guy's gonna see me. That's my problem.
Blink in, neck stab.
Okay. That's true.
I'm calling it out.
Oh god.
Oh god. He's gotta turn around though.
No, you can't see me. I'm in stealth.
He can't see you. You're John Cena.
I'm John Cena.
And next stab. Or slit.
Slit
works too.
Is it just, does it alternate between the two?
I don't even know.
I think it's, okay, so. How do I?
You can take out that will thing to take away the wall of light.
Yeah, but I there's another guy here who I definitely know is going to be able to spot me. Oh, he left. Well, in that case. I'm just gonna go in willy-nilly. Nope. This is what I want to do.
Oh boy.
Whoops. Did I mean to blow that up?
Nope. You definitely
nope.
did not.
Oh.
Oh god.
Okay.
All right. Parry. Next stab.
What? Who's behind me? This
heal,
is the worst.
Heal.
I'm getting out of here.
Do you have
oh,
any
god.
Heal?
It looks like I might. No.
Nope.
Don't.
No.
No
healing. Oh
okay.
man.
I pulled out my heart and then I died. Total panic mode. Shucks. Okay. Well, I got 2 kills for you.
That's fine.
You can edit that, right?
Yeah.
Make it look cool.
I'll, you know, maybe flip it so it's mirrored so it looks like there's 2 of them.
Yeah, you can use, so that's 4.
Yeah.
You can make 4 different stabs. I'm going to just pull it all out and drop it over here. How about that? There you go. So now I can walk on through and there's definitely opportunities here.
Let's
for me.
See. Let's see if we can explode some people with whale oil.
Like just throw this at them.
Yep.
Okay. Well, this
guy. That guy.
Dead.
That
yeah.
guy needs some whale oil in his life.
Oh, that did nothing.
Close enough. Try another one.
Where's he at?
Now where he at? Come on. Yeah. There you go.
Nope. Man, these guys are really strong. Oh, my parry
is
terrible.
He's gonna shoot you.
No.
Good parry.
Well, not good enough. I think I'm gonna die.
Parry and stab.
No.
There
that
you works.
Go. That works too.
You know
love
what? I'll
it.
Take that. I'll take all
You'll
that chaos.
Totally take that chaos. I need to figure out how to heal, because I have nowhere.
Another whale oil guy's coming. He needs more whale oil in his life.
Oh yeah, I'm just gonna throw. Throw one of these.
He's on the whale oil diet.
Pick it up! Jesus! Oh! I'm panicking! Oh, he's just walking around. Okay, I'm gonna go up and throw this at them real fast.
You dropped this. There you go.
Is he still alive? Nope.
Nope.
Got both of them real nice. Okay, so not that many stabs in the neck. But we got some, a slit throat stab.
Some whale oil. Oh, whale and there's the rewire tool.
Yes, I can finally use that.
The rewire tool.
Rewire.
I'm
it
would
5. Have been so much more. If only I had
and a rune.
Yay. That means maybe I can get my powers there for Oh, possession! I can't! Why can't I get it? I guess it wasn't a good enough rune.
You need more runes.
More runes. More health, actually, would be nice.
Pelagius knows what's up. My quota is number of deaths by doing lethal damage to the neck.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, that's all you need to just lethal, like, describe it that way in the headline, and it'll pass. Oh, this guy.
Hello. I hear the second day is when the skin really starts to come all the way off. Is that
keep
true?
Talking. Keep
or
distracting
is it the itching that really gets you?
All right, you ready?
Rats?
Ready. Yeah!
Just a simple stab. So easy. All right,
what
now I'm going to free him.
Mask. I know who you are and what you're here for.
Lovely.
Feels good to stand up straight. Thank you, Corvo.
You're welcome. Oh my god, we got 4 minutes left. Night. Whoa!
of the highest importance. We've got to find Emily. So kill Campbell and make it quick.
Yes,
once
I shall.
Once it's done, search his body for the journal.
Okay.
His notorious black book. And get out of there.
Got it. I'm gonna skip this, actually. You guys cool with that?
I'm
too
cool
late.
With it. I'll allow it.
I did it anyway. Oh, this part. It's gonna be.
All right, you got
lengthy.
4 minutes to kill High Harvester
Campbell.
Yeah,
I don't think I have time.
It's probably not gonna happen.
Oh,
oh God,
oh,
you just impaled
myself.
Yourself.
Oh, shucks. I was like, I know what I'm doing here. And died. Just straight up died. Luckily, it was at a checkpoint. All right, let's go try this one more time. Also, because my health is so low, what am I gonna do? See? Like, I could have just easily jumped on top of that. Obviously, if I was climbing up, I'd be careful not to step on those. Come on. This was real life, but this is video game logic here. Okay, cool. Oh, yeah, just drop down. Sure.
Mac DaCosta on Twitter asks a very relevant question. I just wanted to ask when the next IGN Plays Live is. So, we stream Monday through Friday, pretty much every weekday from 1 to 3. Naomi Plays Live is every Wednesday from 1 to 3. Oh!
It's okay. Don't mind me. Keep talking. Keep talking.
That's pretty much it. That's it. IGN Plays Live 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, 1 to 3. Naomi Plays Live every Wednesday, 1 to 3.
That is correct. We're playing Dishonored.
And we don't know what the published schedule is for Naomi's new horror shows, but we'll figure it out.
We're going to definitely have that out for you, though. You guys will know when it's happening. I will tweet it out so many times.
Where can they follow you on Twitter, Naomi?
At Naomi Kyle. Yay!
Yeah!
So fun. Yeah, at Naomi Kyle. Instagram is the Naomi Kyle because someone else has my handle. Shoot. Okay, wait. I really want to get this guy. This is where I can use this. Except not that. Oh, he didn't notice me. That was safe. Whoa! Okay. It's okay. He doesn't know. I'm going to stab him.
Yeah! Nice. Sorry, I don't know why I always say yeah. It's like,
yeah.
It's like, is it Pavlov or Pavel's Bell?
Just, oh shoot, this guy totally saw me.
I see a next stab and I go yeah.
Take down.
Yeah!
Okay, but there's gonna be like 20 other guys, right? Oh! No! Thank goodness! Not so bad this time. Made it out alive. Aw, yeah.
All right, guys, we got one more minute, so we should probably start wrapping it up.
No! Well, in any case, I appreciate everyone who tuned in today. I'm going to hang out here for a second. So that's it, right? We're officially done. This is our stream of Dishonored because we figured why not go back to the first game because November 11th, Dishonored 2 is coming out. We're definitely going to be streaming that when it happens. So that's soon because we're in November right now. Christmas! Thanksgiving! Yay! Thanks, Mitchell, for joining the stream today.
Thank you.
Say bye to Mitchell, everybody. And
bye, everyone.
Bye, everybody. So be sure to watch more Naomi Plays Live every Wednesday. And for now, have yourselves a wonderful rest of the week. Bye. Hey, everybody, and welcome to Naomi Plays Live. That's right, we're going to be playing some Dishonored today because we're going to go back in time, check out Dishonored, because Dishonored 2 is out in November. Anyways, I want to introduce Mitchell, who is also on the mic today.
What's up, everyone?
That's right, I'm not by my lonesome like I was this Monday. So I got Mitchell, who's going to be checking in the comments. So if you're in Twitch TV chat or if you're Twitch.tv chat,